Quite absurd was my interpretation of what was being said, especially about my own pregnancy, having given birth to Trig 4 months prior, once the candidacy was announced there in August. And frustrated, I guess, that I wasn't believed that, yeah, Trig was really my son. You know, that rumor persists to today even. We're still receiving calls in our state press office regarding Trig and who is the real mother of this child. When did we start accepting as hard news sources bloggers, anonymous bloggers especially? It's a sad state of affairs in the world of the media today, mainstream media especially, if they're going to rely on anonymous bloggers for their hard news information. Very scary. What is the double standard here? Why people would choose to believe lies, and reporters especially not just taking one extra step to get to the facts and report the facts, but instead continue to spread things that are not true. So, you know, I have the same question that perhaps you do and others who would participate in this documentary, even trying to figure out, is it political? Is it sexism? What is it that drives someone to believe the worst and perpetuate the worst in terms of gossip lies? Because when I heard Barack Obama state in one of his interviews on national television that his wife was off limits, meaning family's off limits, you know, attack me, I'm the public official, come after me, I can handle it, and we'll duke it out if need be, but family's off limits, I naively believed, okay, they respected that in him, in his demand for that to be adhered to, naively believing, oh, that must apply to all of us, right? But it didn't apply. This report that Bristol and Levi, they're high school dropouts, and they're gonna just look for government handouts to raise their child and stuff, nothing could be further from the truth. And I've asked some in the media to correct that, and they haven't corrected it, and that gets frustrating.
With regard to the Katie Kirk interview in general, yeah. How did you feel about it when it finished? Did you feel as if it had gone well, not well?
No, I knew it didn't go well. I knew it didn't go well the first day, and then we gave her a couple of other segments after that, and my question to the campaign was, after it didn't go well the first day, why were we going to go back for more? And because of however it works in you know, that upper echelon of power brokering in the media and with spokespersons, and it was told me that, yeah, we were going to go back for more. And going back for more was not a wise decision either. I never saw the interview after Katie edited it, they spliced it together, did whatever they did, and then aired it. Never saw how it came across. But my understanding is so many other topics that were brought up certainly weren't portrayed as accurately, perhaps, as they could have, should have been after that interview.
No, even in the post-election interviews, Dave, that she's done, nobody's really asked her, why didn't you answer that question?
Because, Katie, you're not the center of everybody's universe. Maybe that's why they didn't think to ask that question amongst so many other things to be asked. To me, the question was more along the lines of, do you read? What do you guys do up there? What is it that you read? And perhaps I was just too flippant in my answer back to her, but of course, I read newspapers, I read publications, I spend a lot of time, of course, reading our local papers and the highly circulated publications here in Alaska, because that's my job, is to know the business of Alaska and our communities, but also USA Today, yes, and New York Times.
I believe marriage is meant to be a sacred institution between two unwilling teenagers.
How does that make you feel?
The mama grizzly rises up in me hearing things like that. You know, here again, cool, fine, come attack me. But when you make a suggestion like that, that certainly attacks a kid, that kills me. It kills me.
Did you know about that when you went on the show?
No.
Would you have gone on Saturday Night Live if you had known about that?
I still would have gone on SNL because, you've got a show that... You have to be able to laugh at yourself also.
It seems to me as if Tina Fey and Katie Couric have been treated as almost heroes or heroines among the media elite for what they, the perception of what they did to you. Do you feel the same way?
Oh, job security is important in my agenda here in the state. I'm just helping those outside of my state also keep their jobs secure. But yeah, I did see that Tina Fey was named Entertainer of the Year, and Katie Couric's ratings have risen. And I know that a lot of people are capitalizing on, I don't know, I think some perhaps exploiting that was done via me, my family, my administration. That's a little bit perplexing. It also says a great deal, though, about our society. I've been interested also to see how Caroline Kennedy will be handled, and if she'll be handled with kid gloves, or if she will be under such a microscope also. It's going to be interesting to see how that plays out, and I think that as we watch that, we will perhaps be able to prove that there is a class issue here also that was such a factor in the scrutiny of my candidacy versus, say, the scrutiny of what her candidacy may be.
If, by chance, you had been chosen as a vice presidential candidate for Barack Obama,
uh-huh.
let's mm-hmm. pretend he wanted to be really post-partisan, mm-hmm. and there's this governor in Alaska who's a reformer, she's an expert on energy issues, won't this be great for the country? How do you think your candidacy would have been treated differently?
I think they would have loved me as a candidate, and I've already lived through that more on a local level. There have been times where here in Alaska I've taken on my own Republican Party when there has been corruption, and I've been one to say, nope, enough is enough, we're going to clean up this party and the leader's got to go and we got to start anew. Well, the mainstream media here in Alaska, they've loved me through those episodes. And then though the minute that is that I have done something that is, you know, back to the conservative roots, and we're going to not grow government here in Alaska, and we're going to develop our resources, and that's when even the mainstream media here in Alaska, they turn on you. So there's so much hypocrisy in it all. It's pretty baffling. But yeah, had I been chosen perhaps to run as a reformer on the Democrat ticket, we would have seen an absolutely different, and I think, if you will, a much prettier profile of Sarah Palin and the Palin family and my administration.
Why would you ever want to go through this again?
Oh my goodness, that's a darn good question. Sometimes when I open up the paper in the morning and I see something that I know has to be corrected and yet disappointedly realize they're not going to correct it anyway, so what's the use? That's a good question. I would do it again though, knowing that there is great need in our country for reform.
What do you say to people who really like you, who want to support you in the future, but who might be influenced by the media that says this Sarah Palin is incompetent and not qualified and maybe not even that smart? What do you tell those people to hang their hat on?
I wish that there was opportunity for people, especially in the lower 48, to look at my record and my administration's record, our administration wanting to shrink government again so that our families and our private businesses can be the ones growing and prospering, not government, not people having to look to government to solve their problems, but those things that we've done in my administration, a record there. I wish people in the lower 48 who perhaps would be tempted to be influenced by this media saying that we're just incompetent or ill-intended up here, I wish that they could just see our record, let it speak for itself, and perhaps believe the facts there versus being sucked into believing what it is that too many in the mainstream media would want them to believe.